Not too long ago, I brought you the new name in hi-fi drivers, Punk Kill Day. I even designed some pretty cool one-of-a-kind speakers with their drivers. Now, the thing that made these drivers so unique is no one else really had their hands on them. They're just not really for sale, and so if you want to go buy some, you can't. Unfortunately, when I did that video, I made the assumption that since you couldn't get your hands on them, you didn't necessarily care as much about the measurements or what they sounded like, just more my opinion. I was wrong. You guys called me out on it. And this video is to try to make amends for that. In this video, I'm gonna go ahead and play you a sound test of the Punk Kill Day and give you an idea of the measurements and how easy they are to work with. Now, whenever you buy higher end drivers like the Punk Kill Day, your hope or your assumption is that they're going to be easier to work with. And what I mean by that is that the way that the drivers interact with each other hopefully will be easy enough that you don't need a lot of crossover components. If you end up needing a lot of components, it can really increase the price of your speaker. So you're hoping to maybe offset that a little with the better drivers. And of course, you're hoping for better sounding drivers with lower distortion. So how did the Punk Kill Day do? Really good. Now, I designed this three-way system, and I gotta say, I only had to use 11 components for the entire crossover network. That is really good. Basically, what that equates to is second order on everything, with a basic L-pad on the tweeter and a little attenuation on the midwoofer, and really, that's about it. It was a very, very simple crossover, and it was really surprising. All the measurements were really, really flat, which made this really, really easy to work with. It's insane when you look at the final response, it really is a flat response. Now, of course, if you wanted to tune this differently, you could, but to just show you how easy it was to get that really flat response, I mean, I was shocked. This was probably one of the easiest sets of drivers that I've had to work with. And so I really appreciated that. Now, having said that, there are some things that I'm not a huge fan of on the drivers. Like if I take a look at the tweeter itself, the terminals are pretty close to the cutout. I thought I was gonna have some trouble when I put my crimp connectors on, but honestly, I didn't. It did slide in there. Now, it was tight. It was also tight on the mid-range because of the way they stuck their terminals, it kind of stuck out. I had to kind of angle it in to be able to get it in there, but it did fit. And honestly, it wasn't an issue with either one of them. I thought it might be, it ended up not being, but if you did cut your hole just a little bit too small, well, then you might have some issues getting them in there. I wouldn't mind seeing, especially the tweeter, a little bit different of a location. I'm not a big fan of that location, although a lot of manufacturers do that. The woofer was fantastic. And one of the things I was surprised about the woofer is it actually dug down low. When you take a look at the cabinet, it's really not a big cabinet. It's only 1.3 cubic feet, give or take, at least for the woofer itself. Now it tuned it right down to 38 hertz, which gave it an F3 right around 38 hertz as well. And I gotta say, that's really, really good. That's full range for most people. Now, obviously, if you're one of those people that goes all the way down to 20 hertz for full range, then it's not. But for most music listeners, that's gonna be more than enough. And the bass was very sufficient, which I was really impressed with as well. Unfortunately, you still can't get your hands on them, at least not yet. Now, I'm hoping that you can soon because you should. I mean, I hope that you can at least. So I'm gonna leave you with these speakers playing a song for you so that you can hear the tonality of it. Keep in mind, you're not really going to be able to tell what the speaker sounds like because it's going to sound a lot like the device you're listening to them because, well, you're listening to them on that device. You're not listening to them on these speakers. But hopefully you can tell the tonality a little. And, of course, that tonality is dependent on how I tune them. So hopefully you like the way that I tune them. Another thing to keep in mind is you're going to get a lot of room reflection in this type of microphone measurement, and that's because I'm in a relatively small room, so it's not the perfect environment to get you that audio clip, but hopefully it'll give you some synopsis of what it sounds like. And now that I've talked for entirely too long about why it might not sound perfect, let's go ahead and listen to the speakers. right, guys, I hope you enjoyed that sound clip. That's all I have for you today. If you have any questions, any comments, throw them down in the comment section. I'd love to hear from you. Now, if you want to know even more about these drivers, go ahead and get on the forum and talk to me about them, and I'd be happy to share any of my experiences with you. Now, if you want to get your hands on drivers like these that may not be out to the public, you should really consider being one of my patrons. We do garage sales all the time where the old drivers I no longer use, well, they go to you guys so that you can have a chance using these as well. All right, guys, this is Toyd's DIY Audio, and I'm out. All right, the cat's out of the bag. I got to tell you guys, got an awesome build for you. I got a CSS XDX 12 subwoofer in. This is a 12-inch subwoofer unlike anything I have ever really seen. This thing weighs over 40 pounds just by itself, and that's just the driver. That's not including the flat pack. Now, CSS did send me a flat pack, 67 pounds, and it has cutouts for the speaker, and it's got cutouts for two passive radiators, and it's still 67 pounds. I mean, that's insane. This thing supposedly can go down to 20 hertz in room easily, and with the ability of maybe going even down to 10 hertz. I'm excited about this build, and I hope you are too. So if you guys want to take a look at it, I'm going to throw some links down in the description, of course. And, you know, obviously stay tuned to the channel. Make sure you subscribe, because I don't think you're going to want to miss this one. Seems like a pretty cool build. They also sent me some very low distortion, very high quality tweeters. So I'm going to have to build something really neat with that. What drivers am I going to use with them? I don't know yet, but I know they're going to be high-end, and I know it's going to sound really good. All right, guys, this time, I'm really out. So I'll see you guys in the future. I'm out.